Everyone, welcome back to my channel. So Valentine's Day is coming up. I wanted to give you guys some inspiration. So the look I created today is a really fun smoky cat eye, kind of like a smoked out winged liner. I'm also really focusing on how to highlight and contour for beginners, breaking it down step by step for you guys. So as you know, I am the 2017 brand ambassador for EcoTools. I love the brand. They've come out with some amazing new products that we're gonna focus on in today's video. I also really love EcoTools because all of their products are really modern and innovative, and they're also really socially responsible and eco-friendly brand. So I'm really proud to be partnering with them. I know you guys are gonna love the brushes. So thank you so much to EcoTools for sponsoring and collaborating with me on today's video. Let's go ahead and get started with this fun Valentine's look. I want my skin to be really glowy, hydrated, and refreshed for this look. So I'm taking the flat foundation brush from the Modern Romance collection and a little bit of my Juice Beauty Phyto Primer. I really love this primer. So I'm applying that all over, blending it in with the brush. I mixed two foundations to get more of a custom look, one that's really full coverage and one that's a little bit more glowy, and then I blend everything in with my large sponge from the Perfecting Blender Duo. I love this sponge. I use it just about every day for foundation and concealer. It's great for blending. Then I'm applying a little bit of concealer and one shade lighter than my foundation under my eyes and around the highlight areas with the concealer brush, and then I'll blend that in with the green sponge. So I like to use the sponge a little bit damp because that really gives your skin that like flawless airbrush look. And I also use it to bake my concealer. So I just have a little translucent powder and I'm setting it under my eyes. Next, I like to take the full powder brush and brush away any excess powder under my eyes. I also take a little bit extra powder on the brush to set my T-zone and any places that I get oily throughout the day. And now that our base is done, we can move on to contouring and highlighting. I personally like to use powders, so today I'm using the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. It's a matte bronzer, and I'm doing the 3E formation. So you start with your forehead, you work it underneath your cheekbones, and back out underneath your jaw. So it's a really easy way to simplify contouring. And I also like to touch a little bit on the sides of my nose or under my lip as well, just for more definition. But I've always loved this 3E. It's so simple, it's easy to remember, and you always know exactly where to put your contour. So the fine brush is really good for contouring because it has that tapered point where it will really hit in the hollows of your cheekbones or on the side of your nose, but it still blends everything out really beautifully as well. So I've just been loving this brush. It comes in a duo with this highlighting fan brush. So I'm just using a little Physicians Formula here, applying that to the top of my cheekbones, down the top of my nose, above my lip. I love that trick. It makes your lips look really pouty and plump. And I also like to do a little bit on the temples of my forehead. I wanted my highlight to be a little bit more intense and dramatic, so I'm going back in with a really shimmery gold and the controlled setting brush. I love this brush because it's great for detail work like on the nose or the top of the lip, and I just love the way this came out. And to finish off the cheeks, I'm using the Angled Blush brush from the Modern Romance collection in this really pretty rosy blush color, and I'm blending the highlights together with my contour. Moving on to eyes, I'm taking the full shadow brush and I'm mixing two medium matte browns together for my crease color, blending that from my crease upwards towards my brow bone. I also like to take a little bit on the outer corner. Today I really want to focus on a cat eyeliner and really smudging that out and making a smoky liner look, so I don't need to do too much with shadow everywhere else. So just this medium matte brown through the crease is all you need. I run a little bit across my lower lash line as well. I'm using a really dark brown pencil today for my winged liner, creating that cat eye shape. Then I'll go back in with the eyeliner brush from EcoTools and start to smudge it out and give it that really smoky look. So I did go back in a couple times. I reapplied the pencil, I smudged it out some more until I got the intensity and the darkness that I wanted, but I really focused on creating that nice, thick, sharp wing. Now that I have my liner on, I like to go in with the petite eye shading brush, mixing together some blacks and some really dark browns, and I'm gonna set that liner and smoke it out even more. So whenever I use a pencil or a cream or a gel or anything, I always like to set it with powder. It helps it last all day, but for this look, it's really gonna give it that smoky, lived-in effect, which I love. So using that same petite eye shading brush, I'll bring a little bit of that dark brown and that black onto the lower lash line as well, but I keep it to the outer half to really lift the eye, and then I'm hitting a little bit of that pencil in my waterline too. Finishing up the eyes with a little black shadow on my flat liner brush to really deepen up that lash line. If you want to see a more smoky and dramatic look for your eyes, go ahead and check out the tutorial that I created over on the Eco Tools channel. It's perfect for a Galentine's Day look with your friends. For lips, I want to keep it neutral, but I still want them to look nice and defined, so I'm going in with a rose tone shade today. I'm lining my lips with my favorite By Terry lip liner, filling them in with this a little bit as well, and then topping the whole look off with my multi-stick from Bite Beauty, and I'll blend everything together with the detailed lip brush. Here is the final look. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. Please make sure to subscribe if you're new. I make new videos every week. And if you guys want more Valentine's Day inspiration, go ahead and check out the video I did over on the Eco Tools channel. And thanks again to Eco Tools for sponsoring and collaborating with me today. I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye.